those who would trade our freedom for the soup kitchen of the welfare state have told us they have a utopian solution of peace without victory. They call their policy accommodation. And they say if we'll only avoid any direct confrontation with the enemy, he'll forget his evil ways and learn to love us.
This sounds like political presidential talk to me. And I know people have talked to you about whether or not you want to run. Would you ever?
Probably not. But I do get tired of seeing the country ripped off.
Why would you not?
I just don't think I really have the inclination to do it. I love what I'm doing. I really like it.
Also, it doesn't pay as well.
No, it doesn't. But, you know, I just probably wouldn't do it, Oprah. I probably wouldn't, but I do get tired of seeing what's happening with this country. And if it got so bad, I would never want to rule it out totally, because I really am tired of seeing what's happening with this country, how we're really making other people live like kings, and we're not.
But perhaps there is a simple answer.
Trump!
I am officially running for President of the United States, and we are going to make our country great again.
Alexander Hamilton said a nation which can prefer disgrace to danger is prepared for a master and deserves one. Let's set the record straight. There's no argument over the choice between peace and war. But there's only one guaranteed way you can have peace, and you can have it in the next second. Surrender. We continue to accommodate, continue to back and retreat. Eventually, we have to face the final demand, the ultimatum. And what then? When Nikita Khrushchev has told his people, he knows what our answer will be. He has told them that we're retreating under the pressure of the Cold War, and someday, when the time comes to deliver the final ultimatum, our surrender will be voluntary, because by that time, we will have been weakened from within spiritually, morally, and economically.
But I have to tell you that our country is in serious, serious trouble.
The U.S. has become a dumping ground for everybody else's problems. Islamic terrorism is eating up large portions of the Middle East.
Nothing in life is worth dying for. When did this begin? Just in the face of this enemy? Or should Moses have told the children of Israel to live in slavery under the pharaohs?
But he's doing it because he loves his country, and we love him. We support him 100%.
We don't have a country if we don't have borders. We will build a wall. It will be a great wall. It will do what it's supposed to do. Keep illegal immigrants out.
This is the meaning in the phrase of Barry Goldwater, peace through strength. Winston Churchill said the destiny of man is not measured by material computations. When great forces are on the move in the world, we learn we're spirits, not animals. And he said there's something going on in time and space and beyond time and space, which, whether we like it or not, spells duty.
Hey everybody, I'm Kenny Lee. Get your raffle ticket right now to win that beautiful case. You won't go wrong getting that case. That case is very expensive. Everything's signed by Mr. Trump himself. So make sure you get your ticket and get it now.
Thank you.